I will show you how to create a shader which uses the vertex function, which manipulates the vertices of the pixels in the sprite. As you can see from the top, the shake is applied, and then at the bottom, the trunk is a little more stationary. When the character approaches the tree and the player uses the axe tool, it will cause the tree to shake. First, head over to the scenes folder and in the test folder, open test scene objects trees. Then in the characters and player folder, just open up the player and click on the player node and just make sure the current tool is set to axe wood. Then go to test scene objects and open up the test scene. And then just start to axe the tree. And as you can see, the tree doesn't shake, and it would be good if every time the axe makes contact with the tree, we make the tree shake. So let me just show you how to do that. We go to Scenes, Objects and Trees folder and open up the small tree scene. Click on the small tree sprite here and then just scroll down to material. And in the material, let's create a new material and we want a new shader material. Then in the shader property, click empty here and then select new shader. And we'll use the type of shader here. Keep it on canvas item and then rename the shader to tree shake and then create that. Now double click the tree shake shader in the files and then just choose shader editor here. And you can see that in our shader, we have a vertex function and the fragment function. We're going to modify the vertex function so that we shake the pixels from the top of the sprite moving down towards the bottom. And this will be better to produce a visual effect rather than using an animation, as we can manipulate the pixels in the sprite. In the shader code, let's remove these two functions. We are only going to use the vertex function because we are going to manipulate the vertex of each pixel starting from the top and then going to the bottom, which will create the shader effect. So let's start by creating a uniform float, shake intensity variable, and we'll set this to 1.0. Then another uniform float, shake speed, and set this to a default value of 20. So add the semicolons, and then we'll create a vector2, shake equals vector2, and then a default value of 0, and then just finish that statement. Then open an if statement, and say vertex.y is less than 0, 0. So the reason why we're checking if vertex y is less than 0 is because if you look at the y-axis here for the sprite is sitting above the x-axis, and as we move up the y-axis, the values are negative for the y-axis in Godot. So we want to check if these pixels are less than 0, so we can apply shaking from the top down. So let's call the shake property, say dot x equals, and then use the sine function, then time multiply by shake speed plus the vertex dot y multiplied by shake intensity. Then let's apply the shake property to our vertex and then say plus equals shake. Now that the shader is complete, we can see that the tree is shaking from the top down. If you set the shake intensity to 0, you will see that it stops. So let's just go back to our small tree, and these two uniform parameters are our shader parameters here. So if we just apply that there and then just say 1, you can see that it's possible to modify the animation and the shaking effect from the script, which is what we will do next. So let's modify the material in our script. Let's first just reset the shake intensity property back to its default of 0, 0. And then in small tree, click the script. And in the onHurt method, once we've applied the damage, we can access the material property, which is this here. Use a function setShaderParameter. And then from the shader, access the shake intensity parameter. And we'll set this to 0.5. Then let's use a timer, so use an await. Then use getTree, create a temporary timer on there, a timeout of 1 second. Then we can get the material, set shader parameter again, and set the shake intensity back to 0, 0. So before we test the scene, just go to player, make sure player current tool is set to axe wood, but also on the tree, the height component is waiting to receive the axe wood tool. So just set this to axe wood as well. This can maybe reset in the test scenes. In a future tutorial, we will be creating a tool bar which allows the player to select which tool the character will have so that this is automatically selected. With that set, go to test scene object trees and then let's test our scene. And then for the small tree, let's just axe the tree. And as you can see, the shaking effect is being applied per second. Now all the trees are currently shaking at the moment, so we can stop that. Let's just cancel that. Then go to small tree and back to the shader. And on the shader, for the resource, select local to scene and then save that. And then let's test the scene again. So let's hit the tree and only the single tree is now shaking. We'll just do this one more time and then just stop that. I am now going to perform these changes for the large tree and apply the shaker. Now let's go to the test scene and let's test our scene. As you can see, the large tree now has the same shaking effect. So we can then just stop that window. I will just quickly explain some of the changes I've made. So I've copied the code for onHurt as I have in my small tree. And if you look at the large tree, what I've done is I've moved the sprite so that only a couple of pixels are below the x-axis. And this is because in the shader, we want to check if the vertex x is less than 0. So basically, all of these pixels will move above the x-axis and I want these to be stationary. And it will stop the trunk from shaking left to right so that we just get a better effect from the top down. Then, on the shader, I've remembered to click local to scene for the shader that's applied to the large tree. And then just check the height component is also set to axe wood. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial on how to use a shader and apply a shaking effect to pixels using the vertex function. If you like what you've seen in this tutorial, please remember to hit like and subscribe and receive future updates of more tutorials. Thank you for watching.